Example 1. The tautomerism is exhibited by. If we see this first compound over here, we can see the keto groups, C double bond O here, and there's one more C double bond O here, diketone we have. Adjacent to this keto group, we should be having an sp3 carbon, that is a carbon which is not having any pi bond on it, but we can see that there is a pi bond. This carbon also has a pi bond. Similarly, adjacent to this carbon also, we have these two carbon which have pi bond. Hence, tautomerization, enolization is not possible in the first compound. The reason is simple, that if we do have a hydrogen here, and if we send this hydrogen to this oxygen, making this OH, and if this pi bond moves here, then there are two continuous double bond coming on a carbon, which is highly unstable. So this type of a scenario does not arise. Coming to the next compound here, we have a keto group here. Let's check adjacent to it. This carbon has a pi bond. Hence, we cannot use its hydrogen. This carbon here also has a pi bond. In fact, it has no other hydrogens. So we cannot use this as well. Let's go to the next problem. Here we have carbonyl group. Next to it here, we do have a carbon which has all sigma bonds, all single bonds, sp3 hybridized carbon. So one of these hydrogens can move here, making this OH, and this pi bond can come over here. Thus, enolization is possible. Similarly, this carbonyl group also, adjacent to it here, we have an sp3 carbon. So here one of the hydrogens can move here and the pi bond can come over there to give you a compound which looks like this, OH here and OH here. 1,3-diol, benzene 1,3-diol, we can get in this manner. So option C exhibits tautomerism.